To start with a new set of shortcut, which is control plus all of these. The first is control print screen. So you have the print screen button on the very top on the right side, on the right hand side of your keyboard, which is used to create a snapshot of the entire current screen. So this is my current screen, so you can just take the entire screenshot basically of this entire screen. So I'll just click on control and print screen. Nothing happened, you don't see anything happening, but control, I've clicked on control print screen, and when I go on this clipboard section over here, you have this print item over here. As you can see, click an item to paste. So you have this item selected, which is the entire sheet. So you can just go in any of the, you can simply open a Word, create a Word file. So let me just create a Word file for you all, and you can paste the screen over here, and then you'll understand that yes, it has been copied. So I'll just click on Control V. I'll just click on Control V, and we have pasted the screen over here, the exact screen which I have copied in the Excel, as you can see. So this is how you can, this is a very cool shortcut which I generally use, is control plus the print screen, which creates the entire snapshot of the current screen. The next we have the control plus the home, which is the, which will take you to the very start of the worksheet. So control, home, and see, it took me to the very start. Similarly, control down, or the end, sorry, it takes you to the very end. So this was the last cell which I have used, maybe the last row or the last column which I used. So intersection of the two takes me to the very last column. It will not obviously take you to the very last cell which you have, the very last cell which you have in the entire worksheet, but yes, to the very last cell where you have worked, maybe worked and deleted the item, the last column and the last row. Then we have control page down. So it is basically to navigate across the sheets. So control page up, see, I'm in chart 3, control page up, control page up. Control page down is exactly opposite, which is to move back or to move forwards. So this is moving forward, this is moving backward. So moving forward, you come back to the shortcuts sheet over here. So this is how you work with control page up, page down. Then we have control left arrow, right arrow, up arrow and the down arrow. So with this we are accustomed with, it is used to navigate across the sheet. Control up, control down, control left, control right. And see, this is how you navigate across your sheets. The next we have control space bar, which is, control space bar, which is to select the entire column. So if I'm in this particular column and I click on control space bar, it selects the entire column. And if I do control tab, it takes me to the next window. Control tab. So currently I don't have any Excel workbook opened. So let me just open one Excel workbook over here, any Excel workbook which I have on my screen. So any workbook, so let me open this particular workbook which I have. So I'll just open this particular workbook, a new workbook, and now let us navigate. If it does, control tab, right, control tab. So it took me to this particular worksheet which I have, workbook over here. Control tab, back again to the same workbook. So control tab is basically to the next window. Next window meaning the next workbook, the next Excel workbook. This doesn't mean any other windows which you have over here. I have three to four windows opened, but then it will not take me to that window, it will take me to the Excel window only. Then I have control enter, which is basically, this is very interesting. Now suppose I write a word, say actuators over here, and now you can see the moment I write actuators, all these cells over here, all these things that have turned gray. You can't use the middle alignment, you can't use merge and center, you can't use all these over here which you have. So now how to get it back? You can't use any of these. You can't use any of these. So what you need to do, what you usually do is you click on the enter button, you move on to the next cell, again you come back up, and then you can use these buttons now, these features now. But what I can do in order to avoid this going down or going right or going up and then coming back, to enable these options, you can simply click on control enter. So if I again type maybe actuators over here and I say control enter, now see, all of these are visible. Again, I'll show you all. If I write Shivangi, so I can't use any of these. I can't use any of these, right? But now when I click on control enter, now you can use all of these without even going to the next cell. You simply being in this cell, you can use all of these once you click on control enter. So when in the edit mode, now when you are in the edit mode, meaning you are typing something over here, suppose I have typed Agarwal. So this is the edit mode. Put thing in cell. So how do you put all these, any of these things in the current cell, or how to make this again the active cell? This is not the active cell. You can't use any of these tab. So this is not the active cell. How to make it active again? You click on control enter and you make it active, and now you can use these features. So these were the control and all the very important shortcuts. So basically this I consider to be very important. Control enter, which is very widely used, which is very important to make your work shorter, to make it more faster basically. And then you have all the arrow keys over here. Then you have control page up, page down, again very widely used. Then we have the print screen to take the snapshot, very interesting. So this is how you use the control plus all these options over here. Thank you.